I just felt irresistibly drawn towards music when I was 15 years old. I, with all kinds of nerve, we have a word for it, it's called chutzpah, decided that I was going to spend my life as a composer, but I hadn't really written anything to that date and didn't even perform an instrument.
He had no musical background except singing my father's choir on the high holidays, and he enjoyed that. They never had any music. Everything was memorized, and everything, even the four-part harmony was memorized with people who've done it for years. And so he decided it's fashionable to become a composer. I mean, you know, when you say you want to become a composer, everybody, you know, looks at you, you know. Of course, my mother and father understood how you're going to make money. So he announced to me that he wants to become a composer. He's 15. He wants to become a composer. He's not a bad student in high school. And he decides that that's what he wants to do. So I said, well, I said, the first thing you need to do, I said, you need to get a piano teacher.
First thing I had to do in order to be a composer was to learn how to play the piano. So I started taking piano lessons at age 15.
So as we met, I would say, well, how are you doing? He said, well, I'm going to be a composer. Great. Then finally he entered university. He went into music education. So disappointed in that first year. And he said, oh, I'm a little disillusioned. I said, no, you have to keep on with composing. I was a bully. I have no idea why I was so insistent, because we still weren't really going out. We were just good friends.
He says, I'm going to do it. And he made up his mind, and he graduated high school, and he fought his way into the music diploma course at the University of Toronto, passed it, slugged it, broke his neck, studied with John Weinzweig, got his master's degree. Miracle. Miracle after miracle.
When I went into the Faculty of Music, I really didn't have the background. I was not an instrumentalist. I had never studied harmony. And I'd like to mention Dr. Richard Johnson. And he really let me in on blind faith, because I wanted so badly to be a composer, and he knew it. And so he let me in on the proviso that I could come into the university, provided by the next December I had passed my grade 3 harmony and I was going to catch up. And in fact, when I entered that class at the University of Toronto at age 17, I was at the very bottom of the class. And by the time I finished the year, I was maybe halfway through it. The next year I transferred to a full-time composition course, and I never looked back. I had many composers who I learned a great deal from, not the least John Weinzweig, who for 5 years pushed me, pulled me, coaxed me, and taught me harmony, form, analysis, orchestration. He gave me a sound craft for which to begin as a composer.
Srul's generous recollection of his time with Weinzweig masks a troubled relationship. Weinzweig couldn't reconcile himself to his pupil's conservative musical instincts. And so it was a great relief when Srul discovered a more kindred musical soul in the Czech-born composer Oscar Moravitz.